Hello Aquarians, welcome to my channel Surbhi, and this is the reading for you for the last 10 days of April. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. And if the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign, Venus sign and the name sign. And if you want to get a personal reading, the details are given in the description box below. And yeah, subscribe to my channel please while I'm laying down your cards. Let me see what the other deck has to say. Messages, guidance from the angels for Aquarians. Okay. So Aquarians, what I am getting here with the Six of Cups and with the Five of Wands, I think you want a happy reunion or reconciliation with someone, or you want a happy life which you had once upon a time, type of a thing. And as for now, there is a lot of conflict. You are not able to get it. You are dealing with some sort of a conflict. It can be within you, it can be outside you, it can be, or you are trying to assert your point and nobody is listening. It can be that also. So maybe then the guidance is that you are advised to use some other way to convince the other person. Maybe there is a relationship which you are dealing with, and that relationship is, you are not able to somehow, your plans are not working out, your ways and your things are not working out. And though it started in a very loving way, it can be that also. So things are just not happening, or things are just not moving forward. Your plans are not, you're not able to execute your plans perhaps. And nobody is listening to anyone, sort of a thing. That's what I'm getting. So maybe you're not able to convince your person or the significant other for something, or you're not able to move ahead with your plans, though things started in a beautiful way. And you want that thing again in your life. And because of this conflict, somewhere in your mind, behind your at the back of your mind, you even have that, okay, if it works out, it's fine. Otherwise, you know that you may have to leave, or you may have to walk away from this. You know that. And you have that at the back of your mind, but you are still thinking, okay, it's good. You really want to work it out, basically. It's like that. You want to make it work. But you know that if it doesn't work out, you may have to leave the situation. It is at that level. Or it can be that this conflict is arising because of some third person whom you are not even aware of, perhaps. This third person may not be a relationship only. It can be somebody else somebody who is misguiding you, somebody sneaking behind your back or that other person's back. Somebody invading your privacy, trying to invade your privacy. Or suppose, it's like, the energy which I'm getting is like if one of you shares your talks or whatever time you spend together with some friend of theirs, sort of. And that person doesn't give correct advices or something like that, and then it leads to a conflict. That's what I'm getting. Some third person is involved. I'm not getting it is romantic. The third person who is involved is not at all romantic in this situation. But this person is behind your back. Like, see, it can be something. Suppose you are in a beautiful relationship and that third person goes and tells your parents, goes and tells somebody else whom you don't want to tell as for now, and then it leads to a conflict, something like that. Like somebody goes and tells, okay, they are having an affair, they are in a relationship, they go and tell your parents whom you don't want to divulge the details as for now. It's something like that which I'm getting, which is leading to this conflict. Okay, it's somebody has given some message. That's what I'm getting. It's not a romantic person who's the third person, but this third person is telling your parents or their parents that they are in a relationship and things don't get, they don't like it, they don't want it, perhaps the parents or somebody, and that is why, because this person goes and tells them about your details or your relationship, and that is not taken in a very good way, because maybe your parents are shocked, they are not ready for it, or they don't want it, whatever, and it is leading to a conflict. It is something like that. And maybe then after it can be that also. And then after this conflict, then with the magician, what I am feeling here is that because there is a conflict, you know that like this in whatever way you are following, things will, you will never be on the track. So for them to be on the track, you use different ways. That's what I was saying, that you need to, if it is your partner, then you need to convince them through some other way, or some other method needs to be used. To convince them or to make them understand, and that is what you are doing. With the magician, you have the resources now. You know how to deal with the things, and that is what you are dealing with this conflict in a very new way, in a very strategic way, in a different way, so that you can have what you want, basically. That's what I'm getting. Then with the Queen of Cups and the Three of Wands and with the Chariot, what I feel here is with the magician, you are able to sort it out. I feel you are able to sort it out. And here we have the Queen of Cups, who is a very, very emotional person. And she is a very motherly, very emotional. Maybe you are you approaching your mother? Perhaps somebody is approaching the mother figure. It can be, perhaps, to sort this conflict. It can be that. But anyway, if it is your person, then this person is very, very emotional. This person is very, very emotional, and they are really in touch with their emotions. But somebody here is waiting for someone. That's what I'm getting. Somebody here is waiting for someone. Maybe this is your person or you. Somebody is definitely looking at the larger picture. They are trying to view the things in a different perspective, perhaps. They have taken that. What I am getting is, I think it, because there was a conflict, you start decided to take things in a better way, and now somebody is thinking about it, contemplating it, trying to have a larger picture of it, waiting for something, maybe waiting for a decision, waiting for the next action, what to do, what should be done in this situation type of a thing. Maybe it's you and your person also. But yeah, a lot of emotions are there in this, and then the wait is over and things start moving. Then things start moving in a very positive way, and they move pretty fast with the chariot. So things are sorted out over here, things are balanced over here. But then suddenly over here with the Seven of Pentacles and with the Nine of Swords, something is again stuck, or something is really happening again. Now somebody, though the plans were had started, things have started moving forward, then again something has happened which is somebody is wondering again over something. Excuse me. Let me have water, please. Yeah, sorry for that. So somebody is definitely started wondering as to how things are. That's what I'm getting. Things started moving in the right direction, and then I'll take into consideration this devil also. So something definitely happened which has caused sleepless nights and anxiety and tension. Something is there which is being overanalyzed, and somebody is really, really tense over it because of this negative behavior of someone. Somebody here is very, very controlling. Somebody is, if it is love, then this person wants to keep the tabs on you too much, or this person is very, very controlling. There is a lot of toxicity and a negative energy is there which is causing this anxiety, and that is what is keeping you wondering as to know what next, what should I do. You have built up the relationship, you have the emotions there, you know, you have worked very hard for this relationship, and now you are left wondering as to what should I do, because things are not what you thought them to be. With the Knight of Pentacles and with the Five of Pentacles, love is still there. You want to take things forward. You still want to make things work. That's what I'm getting. But with the Five of Pentacles, but you have slowed down. Things are to a halt. They are just not moving. And because of this, somebody is feeling ignored and rejected. They are feeling upset about this situation as to that passion is not there, that which was there, and things have really slowed down. Things have slowed down, which is leading to somebody being ignored, or somebody moving away, or feeling rejected in this situation. And with the Two of Pentacles, the World, the Seven of Swords, and with the Ace of Pentacles, what I am feeling here is that somebody is again indecisive, because indecision, they have started wondering because of this controlling behavior, and there is a lot of tension and anxiety on this person's part. Though love is there, but because they have just slowed down, things have halted, they are not moving forward. Somebody feels ignored, and again there is indecisiveness as to what to do with the situation. Should I go with it? Should I not go with it? And it is because of the sneaky behavior and immature behavior of somebody, and that is what the devil is for. Somebody is maybe playful, playboy, playgirl type of a person. Maybe this person doesn't want to commit. Maybe this person doesn't want to commit, and that is what is causing a lot of tension and causing a lot of anxiety and fights between the two of you, perhaps. Okay, so this is something, the sneaky behavior of this person is causing all this problem. And then, since you are indecisive, here is the World card and the Ace of Pentacles. So what I feel is that finally you do come to a conclusion, you do come to a decision, and you want to start afresh. You feel that power, and there is, you have that offer. There is some better offer, I think, which is coming in for you. I think there is either this gets sorted out or it's new offer, but definitely you want to take the charge of your life. You don't want this bullshit. Okay, either you talk it over to this person, or and get it sorted, or you feel you will get a new offer. But definitely with the world card, you feel empowered enough, you feel that you don't want to take this nonsense and you want to begin your life afresh, and that is what you are doing with the Ace of Pentacles. And you do have an offer coming in which is going to give you stability, or that is what you're looking for. Okay, even if you don't have it at hand right now, then maybe this is what you're wishing for now, and that is what you want in life. You don't want that negativity, you don't want so much of tension, and that is why perhaps you choose to write a new chapter of your life, and which gives you a lot of stability and which gives you happiness. Here with the Five of Diamonds, with the Hierophant, here I feel that because you have taken the help of somebody who is wiser than you, a spiritual person or even a counselor, or somebody who I think advises you to come out of this negativity. This is the person who is helping you, or maybe you have done your prayers, maybe your spiritual guru, maybe your counselor, maybe your religious person, somebody in your family, a wiser person, whosoever this person is, somebody who is wise enough, definitely whom you can trust and you have taken the advice from, and as to how you are supposed to sort the situation. Go within. Number two may be of some significance for you. No, go within. You are a very intuitive person, and there are many wonderful insights that lie waiting inside you. Time to be quiet and reflect upon the desires of your heart through meditation or prayer. There is no need to take action right now. Be patient with yourself. So that's what I was saying, that because you realize that things will not work out the way they are, so you decided to slow down. Though love was there, but things slowed down, and then you finally took a decision. You will be taking a decision to start your life afresh, and you want stability now. That is what is your prime concern. I don't think you really have anything at hand as for now, but what I feel is this is what you wish for, this is what you're looking for. You just want stability and a new life for yourself. You don't want to deal with anything negative. Or maybe for some of you, maybe you really have somebody in your mind. Okay, so this is the time for you to go within and to understand as to what your heart really wants, and your inner voice will give you the right answers. Number 25 or number 7 may be of some significance for you. Romance. Lavish the one you love with personal attention and affection. So this is the guidance for you. This is what you are supposed to do. This is not the right place to be in. You can't be so controlling and dominating and negatively charged all the time if you want to have a happy relationship. For the happy relationship, you need to lavish the person whom you love with love, personal love, attention and care. And that is only when this relationship or any relationship is going to flourish. And that is what you are looking for now. And that is what you are wishing for in the new chapter of your life, Aquarians. And you will get it. It's not that far. With the Ace of Pentacles, you definitely have a new beginning. And it's not that far. Okay, Aquarians, so that's all I have for you. Hope it helps. And please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.